Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. In this video, we're going to talk about raster images in Illustrator. Now, Illustrator is a vector application, and when you have a raster image, you see this one is placed and it's linked. You can see that by the cross in here. And when you then go into the menus, then you see a lot of it is grayed. And that's, of course, because Illustrator is a vector application and the majority of its commands and tools are for creating and editing vector artwork, of course. But there are some things you can actually do with pixel images. And some of it is quite common, so maybe you want to adjust the colors a little. Let's go into the recoloring. So let's go to edit colors and you see these are all grayed out and this as well. So looks like you can't even do that. Now, the best thing, of course, is to do that in Photoshop because you have much better methods in there. But if you want to do it, if you really want to, well, you can. Let's make a copy of this because I want to show you something else. So first of all, what you need to do is embed this image. Now, as you see, this is an RGB image and we have a CMYK file. So embedding will convert this to CMYK, which is something you might not want. But if you really need to, then of course you need to. So let's embed it and you see it's CMYK now. And now you can go to edit colors and you see some of these have turned black. So some of these can be used. The recolor artwork functionality is really only for vector artwork. So it will stay grayed out, but you can use some of the others. So let's take a look at the color balance and you can really only do just a little and it might turn out really ugly. So some of it can be done, but not a lot. And you could even turn it to grayscale and adjust that black level. So something is possible. Let's cancel that. There is one of these commands that can be quite useful at times, which is the invert colors commands. I have a video about that. It's useful when you want to trace a white artwork in a transparent PNG image. I'm going to link that in the info of this video. When you invert it, it looks like this. So let's undo that. Now, there is a plugin that can do more. So let's select this, the still linked image, and let's go to effect. And this is Fantasm by Astute Graphics. And you see down here, it has commands that you perhaps know from Photoshop and you can use them in Illustrator by this plugin. So let's go to levels. And there's a warning which tells you that you have to activate a certain option. You can turn that off, but I'm going to leave it on. So let's go to OK. And what you need to do first is go in here into the advanced option and set this to auto rasterize. And then we can apply this and we can use these commands. And you know how this works. This is like in Photoshop and you can use all these options with it. So let's cancel this. And of course, there are all these others as well. So you can go to hue saturation and do this. And again, you need to go into the advanced option and turn this on. And then you can use this and maybe colorize this image and turn this on into a kind of sepia look. Let's go to OK here. And the nice thing about this is it's a live effect. So when you go to appearance, window appearance, then you have it in here and there it can be edited. So then you can edit the options. So it's a live effect, which is quite nice. So that's one of the things you can do with images in Illustrator.